Lights on.
Hang on, the light is on. Good evening, welcome to the Halifax Board of Selectmen's meeting. I apologize, my voice is a little shaky today. It is Tuesday, June 23rd, and we are being taped by Area 58 cable. And are there any additions to the agenda? Okay, all right. So let's start the meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Tom, would you like to start with your report?
My report.
The regular session.
You want me to start with the
minutes and then all that stuff?
Yes. As soon as I find them, I will be happy to start.
Well, I'll talk about the minutes because this is prior to you joining the board. But Troy, were you able to review the minutes?
Yeah, I was. Okay. I'm ready to vote on them.
Okay.
If you want, I'll move them.
Okay, and I'll second them. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, how are you?
All right, help me out here. What am I
going to do?
You just want me to read off the agenda?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, don't confuse me now. You said minutes.
No, I just said I'll take care of the minutes.
You want me to take care of the warrants and affirms?
I don't want you to shine too much.
Okay.
I just
need more specific.
I'm sorry, I apologize.
You had me searching for something I didn't have, but that's okay. It's not unusual for me to be doing that.
I told you it wouldn't work.
No.
All right. I ask for decorum once again.
Well, we're in the wrong place.
I move to affirm approval of the following warrants and commitments. Payroll warrant. And for the record, I'm abstaining from the building regulatory and assessors payroll. It is number 107 for the amount of $400,249.06. Vendor warrant 108 for the amount of $21,539.84. Withholding warrant number 109 for $131,655.18. School payroll warrant 110 for the amount of $612,339.57. The ambulance commitment, number 5A, for $15,640.56.
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Nicely done, by the way.
There's one little mistake on that six, but
it's okay.
Another one's in the orange folder.
I move to approve payment of the following warrants. Vendor warrant number 111 for $168,179.98. Withholding warrant number 112 for $189,703.77.
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye. I move to approve payment of the following selectmen bills dated June 23rd, 2015. Read the individual bills in the folder.
I feel your pain.
All right. I hope you all have something comfortable in front of you. You want me to read the entire payee?
I think we're
describing
the
same payee. Great. Radiology Associates of Plymouth, $34. Aquatic Control Technology, $26,658.34. I don't know why I found that so amusing. Again, Aquatic. Or is it aquatic?
Yes.
That's why I found it amusing. Control Technology. $21,810. This one's easy. W.B. Mason, $50.91.
J.B.'s in the house.
Oh, I don't know if this one can go. Pamela McSherry, $28. Express Newspaper, $50.50.
Did they go up on it? It was $5.50 last week.
And that's it for those.
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Tom?
Yes.
Just to acknowledge the
turnovers. I'm moving along here. Acknowledgements. Turnover, 2015-76, $25,000. 2015-77, $1,000. 2017-78, $21.34.
Thank you. Okay, Charlie,
First ambulance abatement for May 2015 from the Treasurer Collector's Office for $5,133.45. Board needs to approve the abatements.
Move that we approve the abatement of ambulance to $5,133.45. Is that correct?
Yeah.
$5,133.45.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Confirm the appointment of Susan M. Lawless as Assistant Town Clerk for the period May 18th, 2015 through May 15th, 2018.
So moved.
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Just so the board's aware, Derek Bennett withdrew his application for the vacancy on the Finance Committee. He will be interviewing one of the candidates tonight, and I expect making a decision about filling the vacancy. He's taken himself off the list. We received a survey from the MMA about the opioid crisis. I'd be happy to work with the chair and the public safety and public health departments to complete it. They've sent it out to each of the cities and towns. Basically, it's what are you doing at this point in terms of task forces or programs or anything else?
I sit on the opioid task force for the MMA, and that's a survey that we put together, so I'd be happy to.
So that's okay to report?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I completed it through my office a couple weeks ago, Charlie.
From the MMA?
I believe so. There were two or three of them that were up floating around, but I'll double check and print off the line.
Yeah, because this just came out 4 days ago.
I think it's all going to the same.
Okay,
same
we'll check it out.
I'll check.
Yeah, okay, sounds good. Water tower contract. This is going to be with Utility Service Company, Inc. for the repainting of the water tower inside and out. It's going to be $1,327,131.
So is that the full job, or is that just the primer?
Was it one coat or two?
Yeah, they put in three coats.
These are here for the board to approve and sign. There are lots of places to sign. All the yellow stickies that say sign here, look for those. Make sure you've signed them after the board votes to approve this.
Town Council's reviewed it.
Yep. He's been working with the water department on this.
So I'll entertain a motion to authorize the board to sign the contract for the painting of the water tower.
I'd move it as a ready.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
While you're signing, I'll move on to the next.
Yeah, we saw 5 minutes.
431 Mont Thompson Street. I know the board has gone to take a look at it from time to time during the last couple weeks. I did also. It's a significant improvement over what was there several weeks ago. The board may want to communicate that to the family that's there, but also to encourage them to continue their efforts in decreasing the amount of debris and other odd items that are in the property.
You know, Do you think it would behoove us to send a letter to him, thanking him for his efforts and to continue the same,
that we do? That's what I'm suggesting.
I would move that.
I would be happy to second that.
I would just want to make sure that it wasn't too much of a thank you, because it's really how their property should be kept. You know, I mean,
it's for the effort.
It's for the effort. Well, what I'm talking about is the fact that he's making the effort, and hopefully continue it.
The goal here is to encourage him to continue.
I saw him working out there today. It was today or yesterday they were working out there again. So,
all those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, you have an invite from the Silver Lake Regional School Committee. They're going to host representatives and officials from three towns on Thursday, August 13th for a meeting at 7 p.m. in the high school large group room. This is going to be to work out some discussion of the 2016-2017 Silver Lake budget process, also a timeline for the district budget. And would like community input on priorities for that budget. So this is going to be on Thursday, August 13th at 7. We're going to plan on a potluck dinner at 6 p.m. Before then. The district is asking for RSVPs by August 10th. I am going to suggest that Pam post the meeting now. And I don't know that we're going to have a quorum, but that will get it done an hour away. But obviously, we still got almost 2 months to go before then. The board can tell me now, or tell me later whether they understand it. I know the invite went to the Finance Committee also, and obviously came to me too. So.
I'd like to ask the Selectmen to try to attend that meeting. Again.
It's my intent to attend, for whatever that's worth.
Yeah, I have it on my calendar. I'll be there.
Okay, well, I'll be honest with you. I have problems with anything past 2 days, and this is 60 days, almost 60 days away. I don't know, but I will make every effort to be there.
Thank you.
You have a talent bank form from Deb Socha, who's going to be coming in later today to the beautification committee, so we'll get back to that. Recycling abatement number one. We have a resident who purchased a property in December 2013 and wants to get a recycling abatement from years 2009 through 2013 because he didn't own the property. However, the municipal lien certificate that was issued at the time of the sale clearly shows the amounts that were listed as unpaid for those bills. And what would normally happen is, as part of the settlement, you'd work out who's going to be making a payment to cover those bills. One way or the other, if they didn't get paid, what I want to suggest, and we're going to have another one that's very much like this, is for me to contact the resident to say, here's our situation. You need to go back to your attorney to get the settlement paperwork to figure out what happened to the money that should have been sent to the town in order to pay these bills.
And that's what we need, and you could submit a copy of this. Settlement papers for us to verify.
Right, and to then follow up with this. Right.
That would be an appropriate thing.
Yeah.
I agree.
So what I'm going to suggest is the board table the request for the abatement until we get some more information.
Thank you.
Is that okay with the board?
Yes.
I'd say I'm really
okay.
So we have an appointment with William McEvoy. Hi. How are you? Hi. Do you want to come down to the front?
Absolutely.
So I had the pleasure of meeting you at a Finance Committee meeting I attended while you were interviewed by the Finance Committee, but why don't you start off by just telling the board a little bit about yourself and why you would like to be on the Finance Committee.
Okay, so I'm a senior manager at Johnson & Johnson from the J&J for 15 years. Prior to that, I spent 15 years in plastics manufacturing, engineering, electronics, electrical engineering. I'm passed a course for a EMT certification. I need to take the test, and I go again this month, which is not likely to happen due to business travel, so my goal is to complete it in the July timeframe. If I don't get on the Finance Committee, my goal is to volunteer my services to the town of Halifax as a volunteer EMT. Just ride along to keep my skills fresh. I do have prior experience as a Finance Committee member in the town of Williamsburg, Massachusetts, back in 1998 to 2000. So I'm not new to this. I have spoken in front of the town. I'm kind of familiar with the process. I do have to understand the nuances between Williamsburg and Halifax. But I'm sure I can go up to speak very quickly. My goal is to give back to the community, my kids are adults. I have really, I'm one of those guys that's always going. I sleep about 4 hours a night, and to me at night, I'm just kind of bored. So I want to get back in the finance type business, which is my background. I have a bachelor's degree in finance and international corporate finance. I have a master's in finance and operations management. And I don't know, I just like to get the skill sets a little bit sharper. Right now, I'm a big source of innovation. A lot of it's more accounting, negotiations, contract management, a lot less on the financial side of things. And from what I understand from my prior experience with the finance committee, a lot of it's, you know, accounting based, but there is some finance. So that's my goal here.
Awesome. How many years did you serve on the finance committee?
2 years.
2 years.
2 years. I was reelected, but I notified the finance committee that I was moving up here.
Yeah.
And for whatever reason, I was put on the ballot and I was reelected, and I had to abstain my post.
Does anybody else have any? Troy, do you want to start with the questions? Because I
basically, you say you were on the finance committee, you moved here. What do you see some of the issues that may be brought before your board? Do you have any idea? I mean, have you looked? Have you been to a town meeting? Or?
I have not been to a town meeting in Halifax. I have been to a couple of finance committee meetings. One for the purposes of I came on the wrong day, but I stayed for the whole thing. And I came the second time for the interview. Just to understand the players' culture, process, kind of get a feel for how it works. Kim volunteered to sign up the opioid task force earlier. If I'm, you know, appointed to the finance committee, I'd also like to volunteer my services for the opioid task force. I have personal experience in that area, and vested interest in kind of trying to solve this problem.
What do you believe that the finance committee's charge is? What do you think the responsibility of the finance committee is? I mean, having served on 2 years, what do you believe?
Well, I think, back in the day, back in 2000, I was a chairman of the staff or going through college and didn't have a lot of real-life experience. A little bit now, I would say that the finance committee is really geared towards mainly the budgets of the town. And then there's a lot of appropriations or funding that needs to take place, like whether it's debt or some other public market instruments that need to fund business of the town. That's the type of thing where the finance, I think, really comes in. Now, whether that happens here or not, I don't know. But in Williamsburg, yes, we had a lot of debt instrument values that we had to do, present to the town on what our intents were, why this made the most sense, take this path versus finding out free cash, those types of things.
It's a huge time commitment, and you sound like you're a pretty busy guy, and I can relate to that. Is this something that's going to be able to fit into your schedule, especially during the deliberations for budget prior to the town meeting? There's quite a bit of meeting time, research time. Is that something that you're comfortable with? You're going to be able to kind of...
I tend to make time for everything I commit to, so I'm not really worried about that. I do have some personal, family stuff that's going on. My mother-in-law has stage 2 lymphoma. My daughter has, an addiction problem that I'm trying to work through. So these will take time to work themselves through, and I will make time for those. I'm not gonna lie, I do also have a lot of business travel. Most of my travel from January to current has been pretty much every other week. However, that's because I took a new role. I spent 13 years, 8 months in spine pathology organization at the Department of Medical Devices and Diagnostics. I'm now in joint reconstruction, which is knees, hips, shoulders, arms, elbows, things along those lines. So I've learned the players, the people, the culture, the process, things along those lines. I've pretty much come up to speed, so now my go-forward plan, in conjunction with my management, is to make site visits to Indiana, Ireland, England, Germany, France, wherever, every other month. So those trips are typically, the overseas trips are typically Sunday through Friday. The domestic trips are typically corporate chats on Tuesday through Thursday. The finance committee meets on Monday, so I don't see that as an obstacle.
The other option, and I don't know if I've talked to you about this, that when you mentioned the finance committee, is we also have another committee called Capital Planning.
Okay.
And they also meet Mondays, not as often as the finance committee, but it's definitely an area where we developed the town's capital plan, and you know, it's a really interesting place to learn about the town's needs and the different departments within the town. I mean, we are so lucky to have somebody so talented that it's willing to come on board, and we really do appreciate that. Right next to you is John Bruno, our town moderator.
How are you?
He's one of the votes in the appointing of the finance committee. So, John, I don't know if you have any questions.
Do you realize that if you're on the finance committee, you can't hold any other position in town? I am aware of that. If you were interested in working on the fire department, for example, and you know that you volunteer, if you could simply be on the fall staff, you can do it with people.
Can you let me know that last
one? Yeah, I believe you could be on capital planning and be on the call board. But I know you're passing your EMT test. Do you have your firefighters 1 and 2?
I do not.
We do periodic, so I stay in house with
them.
So that is an issue with finance committees. Nobody got their job doing it. All right, so that's not a deal breaker for me, and the reason for that is I have a job. I'm a paid well. I don't need to be an EMT. My goal is to keep my skills sharp and current. And I don't need to work for the town to do that. I can work for my business, my company, on their EMT staff to do that. In addition, I have to work for peripheral towns, Halifax, and voluntary services as well. And I'm thinking, you know, a couple nights a week just to stay current on for them. I've been in town, I bought my house in 2010, January 2010, so 5 years. About 5.5 years, actually.
Do you have any questions of the board?
I do not, actually.
Good.
No questions?
No, that's good. I mean, you know, you were so great. You stayed through the finance committee meeting, then you came back for your interview.
All right.
So, you know, we appreciate your interest in the board, and we will let you know.
Okay.
Very, very soon. We're going to probably make our decision tonight.
I just wanted to add a personal note. Purely selfish reasons, I would almost rather see you on a different committee so we can get you on various committees, because you have a great background. It's very impressive. I think you could be useful in a number of different places. I almost, like I said, from a selfish point of view, I would prefer to have you take on a different committee assignment. Perhaps capital planning, if that's something
that
would
interest you. Is that something you would be interested in?
And then you could be involved in other things as well. I'd hate to lose your talents across the board.
I'm fine with that. I mean, I'm all go. I mean, I'm usually shake my leg. I don't know why I'm not tonight, but.
That's your mind.
Yeah. What do you recommend? I mean, capital planning, you've been opens me up for what?
Well,
I was just going to say, it opens you up to anything else that may be available. We had several, occasionally we have ad hoc committees, special committees. You were talking about being on the opioid.
Well, that's really a state, that's usually a state one, but we're thinking about, yeah, we might do it like a regional task force, but right now there isn't one currently. But the nice thing about capital planning is the schedule isn't as intense as the finance committee. So during the budget season, we may meet, you know, once a week or once every other week, but it's only for an hour. So it's from 6 to 7 right before the finance committee meeting. And then, as Tom said, it may ease up your schedule to perhaps go on other things or still pursue. You know, we're always looking for call firefighters. I mean, that is something that, you know, would be a great thing for you and for the town as well. And so, you know, the nice thing about capital planning is, again, you start learning about the different departments and their capital needs. And then, you know, later on, if you feel like you want to take on, and you can with your schedule, take on the finance committee and give up any other thing that you could pursue within the town, then you could do that. But it's a great way to start. The finance committee years ago was sort of feeded by people that served on different committees. And it's really just recently we don't have as many people volunteering, but recently we've had a surge of people interested in being on the committee. So again, it's a really great place to start without a huge commitment.
So I'm getting a sense that the selectmen have a concern with my scheduling, how busy I am, and my commitment. Is there, what's driving that?
Honestly, for me, it's just your background. I just see you being incredibly versatile and potentially fit a lot of different slots.
Okay.
That's where I'm coming from.
Yeah, and the fact that you've expressed an interest of perhaps, you know, being an EMT in town, and that
right.
would still give you that opportunity.
Okay.
Where, as Mr. Bruno mentioned, if you're on the finance committee, then you can't do any of that.
That's fair.
Yeah.
And one of the issues that has played in the past is that because of lack of attendance, I'm able to get quorums and do the type of things in some of my committees. And that's my major concern. At the end of the day, there is a little concern about this travel and right now some of your personal problems. How will that interfere? How will it come? Because we never know. I know as a person with numerous kids, things come up, you never know what's going to go on. I respect that. But just hearing what you're saying on the personal level, you have a lot of issues that are going on in your life right now. And I'm just wondering whether that, and I'm not trying to pull you away from it, I'm not saying I wouldn't vote for you now, I'm just wondering whether that would interfere. And I agree with the care group here that by going on another committee, it gives you an opportunity to lend yourself to give a little bit of feel to it for the town. The finance committee deals with one issue, and from my standpoint, they make recommendations to the town and to this board as to where we should spend money and not spend money, and there are recommendations, you know, it's not binding by them, but we do listen to them. We work very well and closely with the finance committee to make decisions. So I'm not saying that you're not qualified to be on the board, I'm just whether or not it may be better for you to stand down on this one, maybe go for another board.
Okay.
Yeah, and I think your knowledge of medical equipment would help people with the capital plan and the fire department. I mean, I think it could be a win-win for all of us, you know? I really do.
So next steps, the selectmen vote yay or nay for me for finance committee. If it's a yay, I'll have the option to do capital planning, or am I committed to be on the finance committee at that point?
So tonight, we're going to vote a candidate for the finance committee. And if you're interested, you know, if you're not the candidate for the finance committee and you're interested in capital planning, then we can vote that tonight because we do have an opening.
Okay. So let's open that up. I do want to volunteer my services to the town. If you think that my time schedule, my personal life issues are too much of a concern, I don't think they are, but that's fair. If you think they are, you vote me down or vote me to capital planning, I can do that as well.
Yeah.
My goal is to get out there, get visibility, get back to the community. And I, regardless of where I land, I do want to join this opioid task force if I can do that from a capital planning position.
Yeah, once created, yeah.
If I can, it's not so much voting you down or up. There are other candidates that apply for it that have experience and some experience, some background too.
Oh, understood.
So we're looking at all. It's not so much.
Oh no,
it isn't the English.
No, I just want to make that clear. It's not personal.
Yeah, no. I mean, you've got a tremendous resume, and again, we're so fortunate that you're willing to give the town, you know, your time. Yep. I'm just gonna finish.
I was just going to say, when you came to the meeting, you thought we had two openings for finance committee. And there was one.
Right.
Yeah, so it's a little different, but
I didn't know that.
Okay. But I mean, we are so lucky to have somebody of your capacity that wants to serve for the town. And again, I'm not concerned about your time. I know you're somebody that can work it out at all.
Right.
It's really about your willingness to try other things within the town and not hold you down.
Your enthusiasm and your energy
yeah.
is pretty obvious.
Yeah.
And so, I want to utilize that.
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
All right, good. Any other questions? Right. Thank you, Ty.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Back from Kendra.
Yeah.
The next steps are going to be.
Yeah, or you'll hear from.
Thanks, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Nice to see you. Thank you.
Unless you get three more.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you want to talk about that? Do we have, what time is our next appointment?
8:00.
And what is it? Oh, Mr. Denver, he's on here. Hi.
One vote, one vote.
So.
Did the Finance Committee have a recommendation?
Finance Committee recommended to let the chair make the vote.
Yeah, yeah. So I would say that my recommendation would be to move Mr. Conroy from Capital Planning up to the Finance Committee and appointing Mr. McAvoy to Capital Planning.
I think we're really lucky to have candidates that
multi-town.
To have a choice.
Yeah.
And you know, it's up and down thing, you know, we're forced to find it up and down. Sometimes it's low, sometimes it's high, right now we're high, so we have an embarrassment of riches. But all that being said, I like, I see Mr. Conroy work presentation, you know, the question he's asked at town meeting. I know he's been involved, I know he's been sort of paying the grief a little bit. And I think that's important in the sense of having a feel for the political side of town. People have been living in town for a long time and I understand how departments interact with each other and how all things get done in an efficient way, and that's what we really want to do.
On Ponce Pond, the meeting with the Brockton Water Commission with Ponce Working Group is going to be here on July 13th. I'm waiting to get a time to be determined. Letter was sent to Mayor Carpenter providing examples of what the commission and the city could be doing in terms of planning for improving the water quality at Ponce Pond during this year and future years. After I got everything done here, I heard back from Aquatic Control Technologies. They'll be doing the next round of treatments at both ponds on June 30th. They'll be doing the post-drain for both ponds this coming Friday.
Are we going to do a reverse 911 again?
I'm not planning on it because one of the reasons for doing the reverse 911 was the concern that the first go around, I think Eastmont Ponce Pond only got posted the day of that, and they'll have several days between.
Okay.
I'll make the paper.
You'll put it in the paper? Thank you.
Mosquito control, there had been an article about the lack of funding or the cut in funding Bristol and Plymouth counties for mosquito control during the year we're in now. This was one of the rescissions by Governor Patrick during the small budget crisis earlier this year. There were supplemental funds, I think, put in the fiscal 16 budget, but the board may want to contact the legislators about making sure that that funding remains in the final version of the budget.
Do we have a motion for us to send a letter?
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
We have three line item transfers tonight, one for $1,500 from fire wages to vehicle maintenance. This was due to unforeseen repairs, engine one. $2,500 from town building custodial to town building expense for a wide range of work done by the building committee staff. And then $500 from highway wages to highway expense so that one of the new employees could attend a OSHA safety course.
Do I have a motion to approve those transfers?
I'll move it.
Do you have any questions?
I have no questions on it. One second.
I had occasion to speak to the fire chief about ladder truck. We got lucky there. We were able to pick up a part at a local establishment for very cheap money, which could have been quite a bit more expensive. And the highway thinks that that's something that they can handle. So I think we may have dodged a bullet, if you will.
Right, I need the board to approve these.
Yeah. All those in favor?
Aye.
We need the board to sign. We had a letter of concern about conditions at 1066 by Ponson Street. The letter came in yesterday, but before that, in fact, what was happening was the Board of Health, in fact, had visited the property and had communication with the owners to say that they're going to be doing a major pickup of the property tomorrow, I think it is scheduled. So no actions needed tonight at all. Simply the board should be aware of it, and I'll just check in with the board again in a few weeks and hope that the situation's improved.
Because we mentioned the word trash.
Yeah.
The person who runs the snack shop for the baseball, they're responsible for emptying their own trash barrels that are around the snack shop. I'm told that the barrels that are behind the school haven't been emptied since the 5K
Okay.
So I don't know who, I don't know if it's Youth and Rec that's responsible for that, or if it's the Highway Department. The other thing is, she tells me that private citizens have been throwing their own trash in the dumpster that's behind the school, in the tennis court. She said that there was an area that was fenced in that perhaps if we could have it moved there, and like certain people have the keys, that way it would cut down on people throwing their trash.
Is there a cover on this, this area?
There isn't people, well, no, but it'd be harder to get, they'd have to climb the fence with the trash to get it.
I would feel much better by moving it if we're going to put a cover over it too, so they can't climb over it.
Or throw it over.
Throw it over. Mm-hmm. Because if they're doing that, some of them may not even care whether or not it goes into the dumpster or not. They just throw it into the...
Why can't you just put a padlock on the dumpster?
Then who holds the key?
Well, if three people are going to hold the key to the gate...
I don't know if it has a padlock on it.
Well, I can check on which, and the dumpsters, the school dumpster you're talking about.
Not the one in the front, but the one in the back.
Could we put a survey camera over there to see who's
there? There's also a recycling one as well, but that's fine. People aren't throwing things in there.
It's the same ones probably walking their dogs around there and having them dump.
I don't know how many yard dumpsters you had a thing that just went from one side to the other and you send it to the padlock. Open it.
That's a good suggestion.
I think we were on recycling.
Similar situation, another resident who purchased property this time in January 2012 had asked for the 2010 recycling fee to be abated since they didn't own the property. Then again, it's a circumstance where the municipal lien certificate that was issued as part of the sale of property did include the fee in the list of unpaid bills. Again, recommend tabling and notifying the resident that the resident should check with that person's attorney to determine what happened to the settlement check.
I agree. You, Tom? Troy? The same situation?
Yeah, same thing.
So we're going to be sending a letter to them explaining to them what the circumstances are and so that they can contact their bank or a lawyer or whoever.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. I agree to it.
Okay, vacation carryover for Sergeant Sterling. The contract with the sergeants is that normally they can carry over vacation with the approval of the police chief and the board of selectmen, but the request has to come in by May 1st. In this case, Sergeant Sterling is running a situation where the vacation he planned on using this month, he's not going to be able to. The chief is recommending, and I agree, that the board grant an exemption to this, but with the statement that there's no precedent being set in that the his remaining accrued vacation can be carried over in this situation.
Is it that he just found out about the situation, or is it just come
to a
head?
Last couple of days, Chief?
Yes.
Without getting too deep, it was an emergency medical issue, so he had
no idea that it was come up that day.
It's also a small amount. If it had been a couple hundred hours or something like that, it would be different.
I would move that we allow the vacation carryover for Sergeant Sterling with a proviso.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to talk over you. I'll second that.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
On the boiler inspections, the work at the school is going to be done, I believe, later this week. We had safety inspections on a few weeks ago, and the board had seen the reports on this. With the fire department, an appointment's being set up, I think, for next week to get the work done. The town barn stuff had already been checked off in the sense of no action was needed. And I'll just keep those on for 3 weeks from now just to make sure that the work gets done.
It's 8:15.
Okay.
It's 8:15, and we have a meeting with the beautification committee and Deb Socia. And Deb, do you want to come up to the front?
Just the other members not able to attend, but they do want to be reappointed.
Amy Troop had left a message on my cell phone saying that something came up with work and she wasn't able to be here. And then Jessica Raddick left a message on my voicemail saying that she would see me Tuesday, but I don't know if she realized it was tonight and not next Tuesday, so I called her back and said it was tonight, but
okay.
So
I did get an email from Jessica saying that she didn't vote for me to be on the beautification committee. I'll just say that right up front. But there was no meeting held, so I don't know how that got voted.
How many members on the beautification, supposed to be on the beautification mission?
Right now, it's just Jessica.
No, what number did we allow for on that?
It was probably five.
Five?
We're looking for more.
So you haven't had a quorum for a long time?
No. Okay. And that, I think that was part of the problem when I was attending all the meetings last year. It was a gentleman, John Second Kessinger.
Kessinger.
And Jessica and Amy, and it was just always 2-1, or it was hard. So we definitely have to get a couple more people. I did call Lonnie Wood, and at this time with her brother dying and stuff, she didn't have the time.
Yeah, yeah. So Jessica, as part of her message on my voicemail, explained that Mr. Kessinger has not opted to stay on the beautification committee, so he doesn't wish to be reappointed for this year. So, as both of you are aware, you know, we had the garden started. We ran into a couple of issues with the garden. I did contact the beautification committee and ask them to have a meeting that I could attend and just sort of sit down with them to come up with a plan. And
right.
Deb was nice enough to come with Amy Troop. The other two members couldn't make it. And we talked about the need to put plantings in the garden that are require not a lot of maintenance because, again,
pretty much maintenance free.
Yes, yeah. Thank you.
And we did go to Tomasi Nurseries the next day, or the Tuesday, and we did, I have pictures, we did, there's a beautiful ground cover, but not small leafed, a nice little shrub ground cover that's called the Mayflower, mm-hmm. which was really nice. We did look at some bayberry, barberry.
Yeah.
The red one, the red twig one. And a bunch of pines. And they were going to make us up three different designs to show the board. But that garden is much too large. What's right there, I think it needs to be maybe shaped a little different and pulled in a little bit from the side.
You don't think you want to put a walking path through it and break
well,
some
I was thinking, yeah, walking
that path. Way you separate, you got two separate units that you can deal
right.
with.
Right, yeah.
So,
I did have pictures.
Let me get
my camera.
So while she gets her camera, I'll just kind of just explain the, where we were. Right now in the current budget that we have, and that budget ends on Monday, June 30th, there's about $476 that is available to spend.
Right.
The town also approved $500 for next fiscal year. But in order to use that $476, we need to encumber it somehow by ordering.
Well, yeah, the,
we need to order the
yes.
shrubbery really this week in order mm-hmm. for the town accountant not to have
we,
that money go away.
We need to have a bill in which we owe for this year in order to.
Right, and I know that Tomasi had offered to do the design, which was great, but when I spoke with Amy Troop, she said they were pretty busy and they may not be able to get it done.
Okay.
And I've been kind of playing telephone tag with her or leave a message saying, you know, I don't know if there's a way for you to sit down as a committee and just sort of come up with a preliminary design so that you can order at least a couple of Mayflower plants. Like,
yeah,
I'm assuming that Mayflower, like, you're going to also mix, besides low maintenance, you're going to be mixing evergreens.
Mm-hmm. And I can show you the Mayflower plant is gorgeous.
Is that an evergreen?
No.
Because I know that the barberry isn't evergreen either.
It's not a very good picture, but that's the leaf of it. It's almost like a boxwood leaf.
Oh, yeah.
But it's very low. I believe it's only 6 inches high.
It's almost like a portulaca.
Right, exactly. But it will grow out to probably 3 feet, I believe it said. Oh, I can enlarge that. And then we were talking about maybe there was different pines. Like, this is definitely the most traditional, the fat Albert spruce.
Yeah, Albert or a Norfolk pine.
Right. And
if you want something smaller, those grow pretty big.
Well, not the dwarf.
No, yeah, the dwarf sticks are more expensive.
slow growing requires no pruning or trimming. Grows 8 feet high.
And that's probably perfect for in there.
Yeah.
You know?
It won't block no more plants behind it that are flowering now over there? Depending
no,
on where
I don't think
put
so.
It.
I think the sun will come right up over that. Mm. And that's why I think maybe the garden should be revamped a little bit in a way. It looks, you know, maybe. I asked Amy to look at Joey Tonello's plantings out front. They're professionally
yes.
done. And they start out flat and they kind of go up a little bit and then they go back down. And they're really pretty. They have like smaller stuff up the top with maybe a really funky looking tree on the side. Like
yeah.
they had the pines that were not the ones that are
yeah,
circular.
I have
you
one.
Have to.
Yeah, I have one. I just bought
you
one.
You don't have to maintain these. They
yeah, they just almost have like
yeah,
they're even droopy pines, pines or like a
mule. I think it needs to be kind of classical with the
yeah.
building.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah.
You know?
So, okay. So, well, first things first, you want to officially become a member of the beautification
yes,
committee. You fill out your talent bank form. You've run a garden center in the past. You obviously have a lot of experience.
Two garden centers, yep.
Yeah.
And I've had.
Yeah. Does any...
I don't mind getting dirty.
anybody have any questions on Deb about...
I want to know how well she made another garden center before I applied for this.
How well what? I'm a little old, yeah.
No, I know Deb. I don't have any problems at all pointing her to a member of the beautification committee. And I have some design books at my house.
Oh,
I used to do some rock gardens and stuff.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying.
And that was another thing that I had mentioned to Amy is in Tonello's plantings, they also, when they built that little mound, pushed the rock into it. So you just see the front of the rock. It's really striking. And that you could put like a ground cover there.
Well, most displays you start either with an offset, higher plant, and you gradually go down till you have
right.
the edging when it changes, or you start with a centerpiece, the larger tree, and then work with lower stuff and work your way out
right.
to the outside, unless you want to run a path through it.
Right. Well, I don't know how you feel about a path with a bench in it. And we're not talking wood. We saw a couple of really pretty cement benches. And there's a cement company in South Attleboro, North Attleboro, I think, that they have gorgeous benches and they're really reasonable. And
yeah. Again, you know, we have $476 in this fiscal year.
Right.
Again, if we can't order it, and I don't want to rush the process either,
mm-hmm.
but if we can't at least order the plantings before June 30th, that money will go into free cash and won't be able
oh,
to be used.
Yeah.
And then there's
some massive
yeah, and there's like $500 that's budgeted for next fiscal year.
Right.
Not that we need to put all of the money in the town garden. I mean, we could do some of it now, some of it, you know, the bench could come later on.
Right.
But the other thing that we wanted, why don't we just vote you as an official
okay.
member before I forget.
So happy again to second that. I appreciate and very grateful that you're willing to volunteer to do
thank
this.
Thank you. I am.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Thank you.
So the other thing that we needed to talk about, and this was something that came up at that meeting, is we talked about the Adopt the Island program. You know, we had one right at 58-106 where the rolling stop sign can be.
I do have something to say about that island. After I had met with you, I was telling Joey Tonello, and he is well-watered. He has his own well for his area, and they're digging up Route 58, correct? And if there was any chance that they could run a line from his well, I don't know if this can be done.
I don't know if we want to use somebody's well.
He said he will have that professionally landscaped and professionally maintained.
Well, they're digging up, but only to the point of simply grooving.
Move it in.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're not digging
right.
the pavement
yeah.
out.
He said, you know, he'd take it over, but only if it was watered, because that's
yeah.
the most important thing, you know?
Yeah.
The
yeah.
water. So as far as my belief to some of the one on Carver South Street, I would love to just see it mulched. Just a really pretty hemlock mulch or something. Very natural. Because nobody's taking care
yeah,
of it.
Yeah, that's not going to get taken care of.
Right. And so if it's just weeded, maybe a weed barrier put down,
it's also going to be plants that are resistant to the salt and the other stuff that is going
exactly.
to change. And that, if you don't put the correct plants in, they're going to die on you.
Exactly. And I've been in other towns, and they do the big whiskey barrels. And this
yeah.
town did the big whiskey barrels for a while. And in the center of their island, they do one whiskey barrel, and a company is in charge of flowering, you know, usually geraniums or something, something very low maintenance. Pick a couple of stems off of it, put some potato vine or vinegar vine, and it just gives a nice blast of color to the mulch.
Right.
You know, but it's up high.
Right.
I don't know. I don't think planting in these areas.
The only thing that works well in those is if you have ground cover or creeping evergreens or something.
Right.
Well, they're
like
well.
blue rugs
and those type of
things. Yeah. Because like a blue juniper is an evergreen in it.
Something.
You mean the
rug, Jim?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Something
but
that
still,
chokes
first
out
year,
everything
it's
else.
Going to need a lot of water.
You put the blue rug in, then you put down the cedar, you know, mulch around it, and it grows, and it did look good that way, too.
Yeah, that would be fine. You know?
Yep. So right now on the committee, we have you, Jessica, and Amy Troop.
Yes.
So we're looking for, if anybody at home is interested in applying to beautification committee, go on our website. There's a talent bank form, or you can call the Selectmen's office to get in touch.
What would be the first project the town would want us to do? Is it still this garden?
Oh, I would say we need to finish that garden.
I was very happy to see those trees taken down.
We all were. Oh, no, that's not true. Not all of us, but I was definitely on that team.
Well, I would have been happy with two left and the ones in the middle gone, but when they were planted, they were way too, nobody did any homework on that.
They were too big. They took over the whole site over there.
Well, and they were just, there was no air circulation. Right. They were killing themselves out, you know. If you looked from upstairs, it was just all dead.
Well, one of the problems they had, too, is that with the water coming off the building and the frozen stuff, the roots on those plants are getting wet. That's why you had a lot of problems.
So they were growing and growing, right? Yeah. So that will happen in our new garden?
Well, depending on what you plant there, the type of plants that you put in, that's why I did research. I'm sure Tomasa's going to tell them, you know, you may even want to take some of the soil over to them and have it tested for you to see whether the acid soil or that, what type of soil you have. And that also gives you an idea what kind of plants will thrive there and not.
Right.
Because the building has material, every time it rains, it runs off. The concrete and everything else runs on it, and you got a closed area.
Well, that's lime from the concrete.
Yeah, the lime stuff goes in.
And then if we add evergreens, we're going to have more lime.
Right.
Acid soil.
Right, exactly.
So, does the board feel that they want to see the plan before the plants go in? Or
oh, no, we want to do that.
Yeah,
we definitely want to do that.
Yeah,
I'd like to have a view of that.
Okay.
Just to see it.
Well, and is there anything in particular? I mean, I know what we looked at. We looked at, you know, traditional Norway spruces and traditional blue spruce, white spruce, whatever you want to call it. But I've seen, they had some beautiful, they had the grafted white spruce.
Yep.
It was just at the top. I thought that was magnificent.
Yeah, that's really pretty.
It was so pretty. I thought it was like, ooh, that would be gorgeous.
Yeah.
You know, but Amy was thinking more towards the traditional that could be decorated for Christmas.
Yeah.
In 5 years.
Yeah.
Very costly.
Unless you're going to get a lot of manure and throw it out there and have it grow big.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, and that's another thing. No town wood chips?
No.
We will definitely pay the money for, you know, we would
allocate
whatever would be $100 to do. I suggest hemlock. Only because it's natural, it's pretty good.
Redwood hemlock, and yells last a long time.
It does.
I just request no red.
No red, I agree.
Thank you.
My dad lived with me for 10 years. My backyard was red mulch, my front yard was black mulch.
That's not super fancy.
Are you working with the committee?
Yeah.
Yes, she is.
When's your next meeting? When will you get? You don't know yet.
I don't know yet.
I suppose we need to appoint Jessica and
Amy
is still interested, being on, we need to appoint them.
Yeah, so I'll entertain a motion to appoint Amy Troop and Jessica Rad.
Which one do you want?
Can we do it together or do we do it separately?
Do it together.
Do you want to move that, Troy, and I'll second it?
I would move that we reappoint
Amy Troop Greeley
and Jessica Raddick to a term to expire June 30th, 2016.
I'll second.
All those in favor?
So it is a one-day trial?
Aye.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
So how many spots total are there still open?
Two.
Two more.
Do you want to have...
Are you interested?
All those in favor?
I'm not a resident of Halifax, but I, you know, if it comes to Duxbury.
We'll make you a temporary resident.
Can you apply a temporary resident?
Only when he's working on the guy.
Wait a minute. I must knight you with my phone. See, it's a flower.
I've noticed that in Selectmen. You need to watch him.
My niece made it.
So is there anything in particular that...
Well, it's difficult with all the plans and what you're going to do to the type of plants.
We're not doing the plans until we know exactly what we want to put in there. So that's why my question is, does anybody have a certain, do you want to keep it native to this kind of, you know, like the Mayflower?
I understand. I mean, that's a nice thing. But nobody really knows a Mayflower, but I think it's a really nice gesture. I mean, I'm somebody who likes to mix, obviously, deciduous with evergreen.
Mm-hmm.
I also like to see different colors, meaning I like the idea with barberry with, you know, the bluish Alberta spruce, you know, and with the yellowy sort of. See, the problem with albervitae is that the deers love them.
Yes.
Right. And the
rhododendrons are the same way.
They
come in the holly.
Yeah.
They are not deer resistant.
Yeah.
And I don't know if they would make it.
Well, my preference would be if you could get a seasonal garden. In other words, if it's going to be blooming, if it's going to be green, the evergreen stays constant.
Mm-hmm.
But if you have some type of bushes that flower or bloom at different times of the season, I think that makes it for a better thing. That would be the only suggestion I'd make.
I agree. And I'd like it to be a true perennial where most of it will be shrubbery.
Yeah.
But, you know, we'll start out in the spring with all the bulbs and finish in the fall with all the mums. You know, so the color will go right through. Now, question about tall grasses. Anybody for or against tall grasses?
They can get a little crazy.
Yeah,
well, not if we get, I mean, we're talking.
Depending on what type of, you get
right.
Some bamboos and
talking a 10-foot zebra.
A 5-foot. The miniature zebra.
They're kind of small.
Is that called a dwarf zebra?
No, I
like them.
You like the grasses? I like the texture of the grasses in the winter when you don't cut them down and the snow's on them and they're blowing in the wind.
But see, you can contain them. I have them in my yard. One of the things I do is I got the big buckets and put them in a bucket and make sure the bucket went down at least 3-4 inches into the ground. That way the aerial roots couldn't go out and go around. They stay inside the container.
Idea.
You can contain certain things like that.
That's a good
maybe
idea.
Maybe when I planted my grasses in a pitchfork, won't even cut through these right now. So we would put them in a bucket then.
You can put them in a bucket, cut the bottom out of the bucket,
right,
and drop it into the ground.
Yeah.
As long as it's 4 inches or deeper, that way the plants won't go down and go up around the bucket. They'll stay within. You may have to unbind them every once in a while.
Right.
Yeah.
Would you like to join the beautification committee?
I moved that.
Can I second it?
I like bonsai.
We could add one, but then you'd have to do what? Dig it up and turn it upside down in the winter? Is that what you do? If they're outside?
You can't put the thing upside down in the ground. The evergreens will die.
I think Joey Chinello plants his bonsai. He leaves them over or something and cuts them for the winter.
Well, see, I go the Asian style,
okay,
the Japanese style, the original Chinese.
Okay.
They sit out on my benches the whole winter. The key to it is making sure you have proper soil mixture so the water and everything drains out of them so it doesn't settle in the pot and form ice and crack the pots.
You should go to the library because he talks about it. He uses his little stock, talks about the library.
Yeah, so that's where it is.
And
change it. Although, I have to say, this past winter I lost some because I couldn't get to them. They were covered all the snow.
So,
I couldn't get out.
4 feet of snow. 5 feet.
So you leave them out all winter long?
All winter.
Wow. That's
I raise cockatiels, lovebirds, outside and outside Avery. All winter.
Wow.
You raise cockatiels?
Yeah.
Is it a plant?
No, it's a bird.
That's why I was confused. I'm like, yeah.
Not cattails.
To birds. I mean, that was a quick transition. I got confused.
You gotta keep up.
Yeah.
So would you be interested in any hydrangeas at all, like an endless summer?
They don't grow, right?
No, they're really easy.
I can't grow them. I mean, I grow leaves, just not blossoms.
Yeah, that's something good. I made like 7 out of 1.
I don't do anything to them.
Keep rooting on the ground.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Cut it off, plant it. I don't know. I'm just thinking for the blue
spread.
Yeah, I love them. I mean, they have a lot.
You want to get a garden that's low maintenance in it. You get plants that like to spread and like to walk, as I call them, because some of the plants will fall on the ground and regroup themselves and move across the way.
All right.
So I would keep those ones that are difficult to.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Oh, no problem. I will get to Tomas this week.
And it's always good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you so much for volunteering.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
And we have Ms. Trotter.
You know why?
Sorry we're running a couple minutes late. We start talking plants and you just go on and on and on. So you were here for a public entertainment license, and I understand it's going to be like acoustic music. Why don't you just tell us a little bit about what your
basically
vision is?
We tried it at the grill. It's just not the crowd that wants to come in at night and hear any type of music. They want to come in and eat and just relax. We use the entertainment permit only for Christmas parties, or if we have somebody that has a party where they need to have a DJ or anything like that, but otherwise we don't use the permit there. At the tavern, I think on Fridays and Saturday nights, it would be it would be nice just to have a little bit of background music kind of going on. But more than that, we're not going to use it for anything else other than maybe the weekends. Or the same if we have a Christmas party for the employees.
Are you talking karaoke, or are we talking
bands?
No,
I really don't want to get into that. I really just enjoy a little bit of background music, something that seems that the bar is later, from 7 midnight. We have people sitting all night, and it's quiet once the dining room empties out. So it would just be probably on Fridays and Saturdays.
You're talking about one piece?
Somebody with a guitar, yeah. If there's a duo, but quiet music. We're not looking for any craziness.
So now we're not looking at hard rock.
No, cool.
We had that discussion earlier, you missed that one.
Okay. So, Tom?
I was going to say, seeing as we have the police chief with us, Chief, see any issues?
No issues at all.
Okay.
Any particular type of music?
we'll talk about that later. Yeah. I'll put my request after that.
Country western,
Do you think the chief was disappointed that there's no karaoke?
No,
not so much. Not so much.
Charlie?
Well, that would make sure that she closed early if that was that.
Charlie actually plays the guitar.
No, but I can't sing, so.
So we would have a motion. Is it the annual?
There's a stipulation on it that the fire chief just wanted, and he wrote that it must have appropriate number of certified crowd managers on duty at all times if the occupancy load, total number of employees, patrons, and performers is deemed to be 100 or greater by the building inspector. Okay. And that's, I just put that right on here. And okay. You just also need the other thing that you need, which you already have, is that you must have a valid certificate of inspection, which we have that from when you had opened up the place. So you're all set there.
Yeah.
That was
okay.
The only thing.
And everything else still applies, that someone needs to be sober and in charge at all times, tips.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's all part of the tip.
Tips program, all that still applies to, and the magicians can't bring their own drinks in, I think, right?
Right. No, I mean, we seem to be following the same, footprint of the other restaurants that we don't really have. We don't really have those kind of problems. Yeah, I mean, not saying we don't, but it's kind of, you stop it before it stops. Just don't have that. I don't have
also prevention. It's a pound of cure.
So I will entertain a motion to approve the entertainment.
I'll let Tom do that.
Happy to move it.
Okay.
Thank you. Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thanks, Tim, for coming in.
Good
Thank
luck.
You very much. Thank you.
Congratulations on another great business
Thank
in town.
Thank you very much. We're very pleased. Time.
No, we're pleased that you're
good.
Yeah.
Have a good night.
Thanks.
All right.
Wow, Charlie. Back on schedule.
Brockton Casino, there was a MEPA scoping session in Brockton last week. I did send MEPA a letter of intent saying the town's concerns about the water supply that's used by the casino. The town, many part of the town wanted to send comments. They'll be accepted until the 30th of this month. There's no other action right now for that. For the solar farm on the cap landfill, Representative Coulter has been in communication with the solar farm committee. One of the challenges for this project is a net metering cap, which for the national grid territories has already been met. And I'm recommending, since there's legislation now pending before the state legislature, that the board contact its legislators to indicate support for House Bill 2852, which would increase the net metering cap to 1,600 megawatts and expand the exemption so that projects that fall under the exemption number, which in this case to raise it to 1 megawatt, would be exempt from the cap. This would give the project a better chance of actually occurring.
Charlie, can I interrupt you again on another completely different subject that just popped into my head? So 2 weeks ago, I gave you copies of performance evaluations that I had done.
Yeah.
I didn't know if you had any feedback, if they looked okay.
I think I mentioned that last week, but you said you wouldn't need it. I don't have any problems with any of it. I think the work is done well. I think they're fair.
Okay. I just want to make sure that they're all set.
Okay, great.
So I can give them out.
Okay. So I'm recommending the board contact the legislators to indicate the support for House 2852.
Oh, I thought you were done
with
that. No. So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Sorry, Troy.
Plymouth County Advisory Board, this is more for Troy than anybody else, but they're meeting on this Thursday in Plymouth. The exec board's at 6, sign in at 6:30, meeting at 7. I gave Troy copies of the notices.
Yeah, the one thing I can say about this, even though it's not been a good year in general, because they had to lay off 18 people, and because they couldn't get contracts settled. But it's the first year that we as an advisory board in the county hasn't had to sell property or get grants in order to make our budget. So it looks good in that sense. That's one of the things that we'll be talking about. But there's a reorganization coming up this Thursday too, which is part of the thing. So I'm presently on the executive board. I don't know where I'm going to be after Thursday. Just a member at large. So
okay, good. Union contracts. We have agreements with 3 of the unions: highway sergeants and patrol officers. I didn't hear anything back from the dispatchers. For the firefighters, so if the board wants to, these are based on 1% increases that were funded at town meeting. There are 2 copies of each of the contracts for the board to sign if the board wants to approve them.
I need a motion.
I move that we sign the pending contracts for the sergeants and patrol officers for the town of Halifax.
I will second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Building inspector appointment. The board needs to get that done tonight because our current building inspector's term expires next week.
As long as he doesn't expire next week.
Well, I think we ought to, just let him hang on. I mean, he's done such a good job.
Madam Chair, I'm going to recuse myself at this time because of my obvious association with one of the candidates. So I will retire to the audience.
How did you say your name?
No.
Madam Chair, I had an opportunity to make the calls that I wanted to make, and I'm satisfied that at this point in time, even though we have 2 candidates and they're both well qualified for it, I would like to recommend that we go, if I pronounce his name correctly, Robert Pistorelli, simply because he's aware of the rules and regs that we go by in town here. He's done the job for 16 years, and I think that he will run into it very smoothly. It won't be much turnover. I'm sorry, not turnover, transition for him to go from what he's doing now as the assistant building inspector to be the building inspector. Although the other person, Mr. White, was really well qualified for, I caution any time when I see a person's going to move from one job paying quite a bit of money to move down to a lower job and then try to reacquaint themselves when it changes. And I felt a little uncomfortable when he said he didn't like being approached when he was out eating dinner stuff out either, but that comes with the territory. You know, so, and knowing the people here in town, they would approach any of us out there and ask the same question. So I was a little concerned about that, but that would be my recommendation.
I, too, would recommend Bob Picciarelli for the job. He's been a loyal assistant building inspector for 16 years. Again, as you said, he knows the town, he knows the laws, he's on the planning board, he knows a lot about our bylaws, and I think that he, rest assured, that he would not be doing business in Halifax that could conflict with his holding the job, and I feel pretty confident that he will make a great building inspector. So, would you like to officially make the motion?
I would make the motion that we hire Robert Picciarelli as our next building inspector for the town of Halifax.
This is going to be for a
term of
3 years. June 30th of 2018.
What he said.
I will second that. Any further discussion?
Yep.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
And I think the board has something else to...
Yes. Mr. Milius, could you please come back to the table? So, Tom, you serve the town in so many different capacities. I know there's a few of them that I miss, but...
We only had so many trees, though, that we could sacrifice.
He's an assessor for the town. He's a board selector member. He's a zoning enforcement officer. And he's been the building inspector for... 18 and a half years. Yeah. So the board just has a certificate of just a thank you and grateful appreciation for your 18 and a half years of service as building commissioner and zoning enforcement officer. And we thank you for your service, and we both really look forward
thank
to
you.
Being.
And Tom, you can sign the certificate if you want.
Yeah, I was looking at it. It'll be a little weird, but
thank
I might
so
do
much.
It. Thank you.
Really,
I appreciate
welcome
it.
Welcome to the board.
And I want to tell you, I
please.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want me to open it? The last time I got something, I forgot to open it.
1 second. Thank you.
I want to express my gratitude to the town again for all the years of support. It's not easy to do this job most of the time. The building part of it is pretty cut and dry, but the zoning end of it, you're telling somebody they can't do something. It's not the easiest of jobs, but most of the time the residents have been very gracious and understanding as to how the bylaws apply, and this has been a great opportunity for me. I've been close by, I've been able to watch my children grow up without having to spend hours on the road. I'm very grateful to the citizens of Halifax for having kept me on this long. Thank you.
And we thank you.
So Monday is your last day as the building inspector?
Tuesday.
But you will continue here on the board, on the Board of Assessor?
Yes, I'm going to run my term out on the Board of Assessors, which will be next May. And that'll be 24 years on the board.
Awesome.
Well, we welcome your perspective to the board, Selectmen. I think it's going to be a very positive one.
Well, as long as I can pronounce... aquatic properly, I'll be in good shape.
As the great spokesman once says, we may not agree on everything, but we agree on that degree.
Should we tell him that he botched the word again?
Aquatic.
This hydro water. No,
well, there's a reason for my mispronunciation, but I can't get into it.
Bond release for road cuts on 106 and 58. This was the work the Environmental Compliance Services had done, putting in monitoring wells at the intersection. The highway surveyor approves this has been a year. There have been no issues there at the location.
Is that right there on 106 and 58? That around the
Island.
Island.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. It's been, that long, you know, for you?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I would move that we release the bond to Environmental Compliance Services.
Have a second.
Second.
All those in favor?
All right.
Just so the board knows, I've directed the treasurer collector to start investing the OPEB trust monies according to the investment policy that had been approved by the board a couple of months ago. I'm going to try and set up a meeting for the trustees with the trust advisor sometime in July. It's probably going to be a daytime meeting. I'm checking with Gordon Andrews. He's the only person who doesn't spend a lot of time necessarily outside of finance committee meetings in the building during the daytime, but his schedule may be flexible enough. We're still looking for a fifth member. This is the member at large, non-town official to serve. If people are interested, they can contact the selectman's office about that. Cottonmill Dam, there's no action on this. I just got in a newsletter from one of the divisions of DEP. The work over in East Bridgewater continues. Right now, at the preliminary engineering design and permitting stage, you won't see it demolished next week or anything like that. But once it comes down, that's going to be a major, significant step towards bringing herring back to Mount Ponsapon. There are other dam structures and such along the way, but that's a significant
But that's one of the major ones because it holds back the water flow that goes directly into that. Look forward to that.
Pam pointed out that we have Conservation Commission and Zoning Board of Appeals appointment. Was it Zoning Board of Appeals also?
No, just Conservation.
That was on the Bylaw Committee. Didn't you hold on?
All right.
Zoning Bylaw Committee.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, yeah.
No, I thought it was Zoning Board of Appeals.
Because I think, Tom, you wanted to have that under the control of the Planning Board?
Yeah, I wanted to get a decision from the Planning Board if they wanted to take that up as a topic for the board, which I think is probably the best arrangement. More likely to get quorum, and it's really more or less in their purview, the bylaws. They're the promulgating authority typically for those things.
Did you reach out to planning?
Yeah, I did. I'm not sure that they were able to meet at their last meeting.
Because they didn't have a quorum.
Yes. So I'm going to continue to reach out to them.
Okay. We'll just hold off on that.
And it's important to mention, too, that there is an opening on the planning board. Nobody ran this particular year for that seat. So if anybody's interested in serving on the planning board, to fill out a talent bank form that's on our website or call the selectman's office.
And then also you have the Conservation Commission appointments, which the board had held over for further consideration from its last meeting for just to review the candidates.
Yes.
Who are up for reappointment and as to whether the board wanted to move forward on those reappointments.
I'd ask that we sort of take a deep breath and look at the candidates. You know, I know that we had a couple of issues that had come up with the Conservation Commission this past year. I did reach out to Mr. Peck. He certainly is willing to continue to serve. We don't really he's sort of in limbo with the DEP issue. I think he's waiting for some things, but he has assured us that he would recuse himself from any dialogue or anything to do with any project that he is working on. And he expressed to me that if, you know, for some reason it gets complicated and the town would need him to step down, that he would be willing to do that. But at this point, he really would like to serve our community.
Well, for Mr. Peck in particular, he brings a tremendous amount of historical perspective to the board. He's been here a long time, been involved in a lot of different things. As long as he's comfortable with separating anything that he may have that would conflict with anything else the board is taking up, I'd be comfortable with that appointment.
I'd have to echo Tom's sentiments. As long as he's effective and not, the other commitments that interfere with decisions that he made, I don't have any problem with that.
Yeah, perfect. I just wanted to reach out just because of the year that we had, the issue that we had experienced.
That was the right thing to do.
So
he's up for reappointment, and Mr. Gerald Fitzgerald is also up for reappointment.
And I believe he's expressed interest in being reappointed.
As far as OPM,
did he say yes?
He did. Okay.
He did, yeah.
Okay, perfect. Yeah.
I would be happy with that as well.
So do I have a motion from the board?
I'll move it, both Mr. Peck and Mr. Fitzgerald, to be reappointed. How long is the term?
For 3 years, until June 30th of 18.
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Halifax, I'm going to skip over what we're going to be dealing with the police chief in a few minutes, but Halifax Lights, they do need an entertainment permit for a DJ for this coming Saturday from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. near the Hops Playground.
I just kind of give a quick update to, there will not be activities on the town green due to sort of the lack of volunteers, and so the decision was made that we would still continue to have fireworks because funding is in place for that. But the any activities that we have will be 6 to 9 across the street in the Hops area. So right now we have a juggler that is being paid for by a grant. We have a face painter. We have a balloon maker. And we have Hops selling their famous lemonade that they sold last year. And then the fireworks will take place somewhere around 8:45.
8:45 or 9:15?
Oh, is it 9:15?
I thought it was 9:15.
Okay. All right, yeah. No, that's fine. Stick with your number.
It'd be a little bit dark.
Yeah, true.
So if the board would approve the live entertainment permit for the Halifax and Lights?
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
A few months ago, I talked with the board about opening the building up on Fridays. This does not mean that all the offices would be open, and I didn't get any pushback from the offices in general about opening. We're going to obviously have situations where residents come in expecting Office X to be open. They're not going to be. We'll have a large poster board up at the front door to indicate which offices are going to be open that particular Friday for what hours, because people's schedules and availability changes on a week-to-week basis. We'll try to have some information if someone's coming in to try and work with Office X and they're not going to be open. Here's what you can do, at least have phone numbers, or you can do something online or whatever, you know, forms are going to be available, something like that. But I know having people get to the door and having it locked on them on Fridays where the rest of the world is operating on Friday really sends a terrible message to the townspeople and to our visitors in Halifax. It's not a perfect solution. It would be better if the offices were, all the offices were open, but it's a starting point. Maybe we can work on that 12 months from now. Maybe we can have more hours for more of the offices at this point.
So it sounds pretty positive from the other offices.
A lot of offices are closed, and that's not going to be changed. But
So you want to do it every Friday or every other Friday?
No, every Friday.
Every Friday you want to have it open from what time to what? The regular hours?
Normal 8 to 4.
8 to 4? Yep.
The building will be open, not all the offices. I can imagine possibly a situation once or twice that if the last person's in the building and they're leaving at 2 o'clock for some reason, then we'll post accordingly.
Right.
I don't want to leave the impression there'll be a lot of people here,
right,
because that definitely will not.
Most of the offices are closed on Fridays. Yep. That's how it is, and it's going to stay, at least for the foreseeable future.
But to your point, at least somebody can get into the building and then get frustrated.
And at least, if nothing else, they can at least talk to someone, get some information when the offices might be open, or put a message in the mailbox that the person was in to see them, you know, concerning a certain matter. So I think it's a good idea to work. I never liked the idea of closing on Friday. I understood why we did it. Don't get me wrong. The same time we cut off our street lights and everything else, I still didn't like it. But
well, you know,
necessary.
Of course, you know, I don't know if everybody understands how this all works in the building here. I mean, we have elected boards, we have appointed boards. The elected boards choose their own hours, and there's nothing we can do really to influence any of that. But we can influence our own department. And to Charlie's point, and I agree with him, at the very least, you have the ability to come in and talk to somebody in the building so you feel like you've at least made some contact as opposed to being shunned at the door. And I think it's a good thing. And if some of the elected offices want to revisit their scheduling, they could probably do something about, but of course that's up to them.
Right. And,
I think it's a worthy thing to do.
Yes, I appreciate a motion. Yes.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
And another minor thing, I brought this up a few months ago about live entertainment permits. About a number of months ago, we cut out the $5 charge for tag sales because it didn't make any sense given the amount of work involved in doing a turnover even and such, there was a little point. What I'm suggesting is not for, obviously, for instance, when we just did the Lionville Tavern, that's a commercial operation and such, and that's a separate type of public entertainment license. But the ones that we issue where there's amplified music and such for weddings or graduation parties, birthday parties, things like that, block parties, what I'm going to suggest is that, and the board doesn't have to do it tonight, but the board consider waiving the $5 fee for the non-commercial live entertainment events. Simply, again, there's a little point. If it's supposed to be making money, it makes so little money for the town over the course of the year, the $5 isn't material, and it's just another, it's more of a burden on us than actually to do the turnover. And then you're saying to someone, it's $5. Well, whether it doesn't do anything for them in trade.
I totally agree. The time involved and the effort involved and just tracking the $5 isn't worth the effort.
Well, I'm sure we pay the secretary more than $5 an hour for her to take that time to write up the paperwork and stuff. And then
it involves multiple departments.
Yeah. Well, they still have to.
They still have to come in and register because if we get a complaint, then they'll have the permit on hand and everything. Yeah. And the stipulations will still exist or something like that. The board will still go through the approval process. I'm just suggesting that the fee be waived, that's all.
So do you feel comfortable voting that now?
I don't know.
Troy?
I mean, it's pretty straightforward. There's nothing ridiculous about it. Yes, I would vote that we waive the $5 fee for the listed events, such as graduations, weddings, and non-commercial parties or events.
I'll second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Pam, I mentioned that we had missed one of the appointments, I think, from Municipal and School Building Committee, did you say, for Ken Vinton?
Well, Ken didn't think that he wanted to be reappointed, okay. He just opened up to somebody else.
Right.
But then nobody came forward, and so he says, okay, I want to be reappointed. But then Jerry said, oh, well, there's a talent bank form. He found there was one in the file cabinet, so I sent it to Jerry, but I don't know what Jerry wants to do with it.
Jerry has a talent bank for another gentleman.
So we'll probably get the contact with her and say, hey, what do you want to do?
If they're interested in having this person appointed, then they can have this person, then they can tell us, we can set the interview for the 14th of July and move on from there.
Okay.
Road cuts, you mentioned two, one for 14 Lake Street, the other for Montpont and Lincoln Streets.
Right, okay. Lake Street is still holding off on because I have to get some more information. but Montpont Street is in your pile under discussions. And it's for just to replace the test box cover. They're doing a lot of maintenance work around.
Who's that?
Columbia Gas. We're going to do that all this summer, doing test box covers, maintenance work.
Yeah, you can see the work right up at the intersection. You see the red raised covers, the yellow raised covers.
Yep.
So did you look at it? Did you feel comfortable? Everybody signed off on it?
Everybody signed off on it. Okay. Yep, one detail officer. Okay. Other than that,
no bond, nothing, we're all set.
No, because they're just they're changing the piece of equipment that's already there. They're not even cutting up the road at all.
Okay. So do I have a motion to approve the road cut?
I'll move that.
Second.
So we approve the road cut.
All those in favor?
Right.
Aye.
And Pam, is there anything else that I've missed?
No, that's it.
Okay.
So outside going to executive session on security matters concerning the town with the street.
Yes.
Need to sign the list.
So I need a motion to go into executive session in order to discuss the security of the town.
Second. Yes.
Yes, Troy. Yes.
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 Actually,
Troy.
Troy seconded. Nobody moved. So
I moved.
Oh, Kim moved. Oh, okay. I didn't.
I don't know. My voice is going away.
Well, you made it. You made it this far. this far.
I made it this far. Everybody's going to be so happy.
We're moving to go into executive session. We're not going to come out of executive session to go back into public session. There'll be no announcements made.
And no, no editorials by the reporters or talking to them?
We do have a special meeting scheduled for next Tuesday, June 30th at 7:30. We're dealing with some poll hearings and I think one live entertainment permit.
And that's
it. Yeah, it's going to be super quick.
By poll hearings, you mean flagpole?
No.
No.
Electrical
poll, telephone polls.
Or what? Okay.
And we're not talking about the foreign country.
Okay. My mind is something else, but so there's nothing
exciting.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, nice to see you, Ed.
Good to see you, too.
Have a happy 4th of July.
Yes, and a happy fiscal new year.
And just remember.
A happy fiscal new year, that's awesome. That is so great.
Very good.
Thank you. I'm going to use that. Where did you get that from?
I used it at the time.
That was
originally it, but
no, it's awesome.
Trademark it.
Yeah.
You should. That was good.
Have a great night.
Bye.
Good night. Good night.
Drive safely.
It's cool.
You can tell like it's smooth.
I love it. I'm so excited. Like a new day.
We're gonna
drop the ball.
Are we done, folks? Then yes. She can turn the red light off?
Yes.
We are.
I am.
You can't go home, but you can turn the light on.
We can drop like a money ball.